Iranian clinics ordered to report pregnant women to prevent abortion. In Iran, a leaked letter from the Justice Ministry of Mazandaran province in Iran called for the organized reporting of women who tested positive for pregnancy, seemingly to fend off criminal abortions. The critics are theorizing that Iran is using this order to bolster the country's low population growth rate. ABC News reported that Mahdiar Saidian, a Iranian medical journalist, leaked the Justice Ministry's letter through Twitter. According to Saidian, one of the plans to prevent abortion is organizing and connecting laboratories and clinical centers to introduce mothers with positive pregnancy test results. In response to the backlash on social media, a local state-operated TV channel televised an interview with the crime prevention deputy. According to the interview, the plan described in the leak letter was meant to prevent, quote, unprofessional abortions.
Wait, unprofessional abortions means that there are professional abortions that are allowed?
So, yes, in Iran, you are allowed to get an abortion if you are married and if the pregnancy and some abnormality with the pregnancy is directly threatening the life of the mother. However, it's really important to note that it is illegal and there are no options available to you if you are not married.
Shouldn't there be more options available to you if you're not married? Like, isn't that a more cause for concern?
No. That's not the case.
But
that's not allowed.
What? Okay. All right. It should be the other way around, I guess. It should all be allowed. So it's weird that when you have less support, they force you more to carry the child when you have less support to raise a child. Okay. Mm-hmm, I guess they just hate. Mm-hmm. Okay. Seems like, yeah, like, hey, let's just try to act like we hate women. But go on.
There is a conservative push for a bill that would restrict abortions even further, which would then require the medical team's diagnosis. Again, you would have to be married for you to even apply to any of this. So married, a medical team's diagnosis, as well as two faqis or religious.
Agree.
Thank you. Agree. my throat doesn't do that. So you need the approval of two religious experts to then on top of the medical diagnosis to get an abortion. But at this point, it's a very controversial bill that hasn't been ratified. But there is an even further push to constrain it even more, which is personally terrifying as a woman, that you could have a condition that poses a legitimate threat to your life and a doctor could agree, but you need to then get the approval of two random religious dudes to say, like, yes, your life can be spared, when they know nothing about, like, what's actually physically going on in your body, the pain you're going through, like anything like that.
I mean, the fact that you even have to make that case, like, that means, like, other people that don't have the threat, don't get that abortion. So that would be, and that's not the case yet, right? Is that what you're saying? Right. Okay. And this is about Mazandaran, which is a province. What is the case right now for most women in Iran? If it's not life threatening and they want to get an abortion, is an abortion right now available to them?
No.
Because I know it keeps changing. No. Because I know this keeps changing because my mom had to experience with this before. She told me, like, earlier in the after the Islamic Revolution in Iran, it was completely banned. And then apparently later on, I don't know if it was not banned or is it because my mother had access to better healthcare through my dad, who was a doctor, that she, I don't know how it worked, but I know she got an abortion later with a doctor. And it keeps getting, like, I think it was, like, strict before and then it got less strict. And now it's going back to becoming strict. So I think, like, your experience might vary based on what year you were trying this. But I know my mom actually did got an, you know, when she first got pregnant, she was a university student in Iran, and she went from one doctor to another doctor trying to get an abortion, and she was constantly getting rejected, and she was like so desperate for it. And the last doctor, he told her, like, look, I can't get to do this for you because it's illegal, but I could show you how to do it with a coat hanger. I could tell you how to do it with a coat hanger. And the doctor told my mom, and she told me that she did. She remembered watching the fetus just doing like rounds in the toilet when she was flushing it. And she was like, that was the most traumatic experience, just watching the fetus go down the toilet. And she said that she passed out on her bed. And when she woke up, she was like, she had bled so much that the entire mattress was red with blood. And at first, the person that came into the room was the cleaning lady. This was at her dorm in the university. And she was like so shocked, and she was so upset with all the blood. But then she realized that at first she was like angry and screaming. But then she looked at my mom and she realized that this lady is about to die because of all the blood. And then she like her mood switched and she helped her. And if my mom says if that cleaning lady didn't come into the room, she would be dead because of all the blood.
So many women die that way. So many women die that way.
Yeah. So she said like she got lucky that there was actually cleaning that day. But hey, this would happen. This is what, as a result of getting abortion illegal, you get women almost dying because they're using coat hangers. Iran going backward. By the way, compare this with the Texas situation, because in Texas, like people, like I think you can't do this in Texas anymore because I think it was challenged. But for a very short time, what was being suggested is that people could go report women or other people who helped, not legally reporting and for doing something illegal, but in a civil court. Sue them for trying to commit for getting an abortion. But look how much more extreme this is. You're reporting people not even for getting an abortion. You're reporting them for being pregnant. Like you're chasing after people and reporting them to the government. Like this woman would be pregnant. She might want to hide it. She might want to hide it, but I want this to be on record that she be pregnant. So if she doesn't give birth, she did an abortion. Something shady would happen. Like that's how extreme this is. But yeah, go on.
So I need to correct you on something you said about Texas. So you said it was like maybe not in effect. You're talking about SB8. It was a law that was enacted in Texas recently. There was a very small like judicial pause on it, which was very quickly revoked. So it's back in effect. It's in full effect. But what you said otherwise is correct. It is not criminally punishable, and you cannot target the woman herself, but you can in civil court, and you actually are rewarded with a bounty for doing this if it goes through, for a minimum of $10,000. You can civilly prosecute anyone who aided or abetted her in that abortion process, which could be like literally anyone who went with her to hold her hand, someone who drove her there, the abortion provider themselves, or alleged abortion provider. It has a massive chilling effect on society in many ways.
Yeah, but the key difference that I wanted to highlight is that those reports are for abortion. In Iran, these reports are for just being pregnant. You're just like, I just noticed this woman tested positive. Like, who's doing the reporting?
So it's the idea that if you go like to get your labs done to check if you're pregnant, like that will be recorded and reported. And theoretically with the idea to connect you to a clinical center, but then it's like, well, what would the clinical center do? Are they supposed to like follow your pregnancy the whole time? Be like, well, woman, haven't come in. Tests? Like, what happened to that pregnancy? Not clear what any mechanism of punishment would be. And I actually don't know what the penalty for procuring a criminal abortion is in
But don't they have the thing that you could just test at home with peeing on a strip? Like, is that not? I think that's a
very common era.
Yeah, okay. It's probably is okay. Anyway, this is gonna make movements like
problem
this.
That...
Let me finish this. This is actually, if this is like being reported, a movement like, oh, if you go to a lab and get tested, they could report you to the government and they're gonna monitor you to make sure you're not getting abortion. This is gonna. Is this not going to lead to women not getting some important tests done?
Yes, that's exactly what I was about to say. Activists are talking about how this is going to demotivate women from like going and getting their health and their checkups and stuff.
Because sometimes you might going to go do some blood work from other things that you might need to get checked.
And you find out you're pregnant.
Yeah, and you're like, I don't want the lab to be recording my blood, reporting my blood work to the government. So less people are going to get checked up, and that's like dangerous. Amazing. Mm-hmm. Amazing. It just every day we find new ways for religion like to screw with our lives, like, but it's just like more creative ways.
As our local, aka the best Iranian analyst,
oh wow,
it's true. What do you think about the theories that some people have put forward that this is about the very low population growth rate in Iran right now? People aren't having the babies.
Well, I mean, this is Khamenei's concern. He, a couple of years ago, he came out and said, like, we need more babies. We need to be making an Islamic army, and our women are not making enough kids. And this needs to, and this was my first, because I grew up in an environment where it was easy for my mom, at least, to, like, Iran had progressed enough out of the early years of the revolution, for at least for people who are as well off as my mom eventually, to be able to have access to anything that, you know, stop a pregnancy, avoid a pregnancy, get an abortion. And then I remember a couple years ago, Khamenei came out and like, we need to push forward with like making these things less available because we need to grow the ummah, right? And these are, I don't think like this is in response to people actually making like a population calculation, academic study. This is like, this is Khamenei's wish. We need to respond to this desire by our religious leader. This is a response to his demand, more like a, you know, scientific calculation of, you know, population adjustment and stuff like that. I don't know. I mean, we literally have a religious leader that believes that the enemies are speaking to demons, and that
cool.
and that the
Great.
Whole thing, and the whole jabby jab thing in response to the whole sickness that is going around that we're not going to mention, he thinks that was, he came out and openly said nationally that this could be an attack on the Iranian DNA. Okay, this whole mess that we're dealing with, all of us, could have been designed as a way to target Iranians.
That led to the deaths of hundreds of thousands of his own citizens.
Yeah, because
you know, maybe better addressing issues like that would help the growth rate long term.
Yeah, that's, yeah, maybe if you're dealing with a population issue, maybe don't kill your citizens by stopping
criminal negligence or execution.
Yeah, good point. Actually, I hope people understand what we're talking about, guys. We're limited even by what we can say on YouTube because they're sensitive about certain keywords. So I hope you guys know what we're talking about. People get it, right? Let us know in the live chat if you get it. Anyways, so
do we need a decoder ring? Like, oh, what do you mean?
All right. Yeah, the secular is like, damn, drop the mic, Susanna. Yeah, that's a very good point, Susanna. Good job.
Hey guys, if you're a fan of Blasphemy and Sexy Callie, you know, like me, then you need to be sure to subscribe to our newsletter, link in the description below. Because if you subscribe, we will send you a free copy of our Blasphemous Art ebook. And let me tell you, it is the tastiest Blasphemy that you can find anywhere available today. And we are so generous with our Blasphemy that we continue to send you more Blasphemy every week. So make sure to subscribe. Link in the description below.